Hi guys, welcome back to Selenium Framework Design from Scratch and the Red Practical Hands-On. So in the previous video, we have seen how to work with one of the major components, one of the build component, that is a build tool that we have been working with. We have seen how to configure all the things and all the dependency configuration, plugin configuration, a basic idea of the form XML file and the effective form. Everything has been covered. So let's have a quick recap of whatever was covered as a part of the previous video. Practical Maven. So we have seen how to configure basically from dependency stack. Just by clicking on add, we can configure the dependencies. This is what we have seen basically. And then we can also define the scope of this dependency, compile its scope is related to compilation phase or runtime or test or system. So what are the phases was related to? So basically we are going to use a framework design, the compilation and the test phase. So we basically see all the dependencies that were related to compilation phase or the test phase. The scope of this dependency is related to compilation or test. So let's see some of the dependencies which we have configured in the form.xml file. So Selenium, TestNG, Apache Phone, and XInterpose API, these are the dependencies which we have configured. And the scope of these dependencies, and we have seen the scope of these dependencies in the parent form.xml file, where Selenium scope is for compilation, as we already discussed. Selenium dependency, Apache Phone dependency, and the extent reports, these are the APIs which we are utilizing in our framework, and we are writing code based on utilizing this framework, these APIs. Selenium has provided an API using which we will be able to communicate with the browser or the application in the browser. And similarly, Apache Phone has provided an API that comes up with working with Excel sheets and all those things. And similarly, Action Reports is an API which is used for repeating purpose. So you can play with the API and customize the reports in a defined manner. So these are for compilation phase. Why it is for compilation phase? Because we are going to write the code, and the code which we have written that needs to be compiled to binary files, from where the TestNG will pick up these codes, these execution statements, and then it will start executing on the browser, or it will be doing the specified task based on those defined in the binary file. So binary file consists of line by line statement, I mean the execution steps that needs to be done, that has been compiled from the source files, and it was placed to that execution step. That code has been modified to the system dependent format in the binary file, and then using that format of which was able to communicate with the system, the task will be able to communicate with the system environment. I mean, based on the environment, it will be utilized. So if it is a Mac OS, if it is a Windows OS, that binary file is common for everything. And that binary file has a sequence of steps that has been defined to do a particular task, and based on that, it will be doing the particular task. So that will be utilized by the test environment, that is the test execution phase that is used by JRE library, where it is a platform for execution. So TestNG, the scope of TestNG is test. So it is used for running the test. As we already know, it's a unit testing framework which is used for running our tests. So it compiles, and then the compiled source files will be run on the particular environment using the TestNG. The Java execution library, JRE, will be utilized, and then it will be running. It will be executing the binary files on the particular platform. So what are the other things which we have discussed? We have seen all the configurations related to the central repositories, the plugin central repository, and the dependency central repository over here, and then how is the our project structure constructed. You can see when you are saving the things, it was building. You can see a building workspace that comes at the lower corner, right lower corner, which defines. So at the initial step, the project has been framed out based on these configurations. The directories have been framed out using these configurations. So this is a configuration where the source files will be placed, and the test source files will be placed in the output directory where the source binary files will be placed. And this is the test output directory where our test binary files will be placed, and the resources path, etc. And the final name which needs to be constructed up with. This is the final name as I already defined. How our artifact will be produced, that the jar file will be produced with Selenium framework method, the version number, and where it will be placed. It will be placed under this particular folder directory, that is under the target directory. We will be getting the jar file with this particular name. So if you wanted to utilize this particular project in any other project, we can take that part jar file and we configure this dependency, and we can specify this is the path where to get the dependency, where to get this particular dependency from. And then in that particular project, this jar file will be induced. And we have seen the plugins. What are the basic plugins that are available as a part of configure, as a part of form.xml file parent form? So now, why we are going to override the compiler plugin and the surefire plugin. So basically, why we wanted to override those things in our project is like, assume like we wanted to compile a project with Java 1.5 or Java 1.8. So we need to use the compilation phase. The Java library that needs to be used is 1.5 or 1.8. So to define that, we are overriding. And also, why we are overriding using overriding the surefire plugin? Why we are overriding is basically because we are mentioning where is the configuration file from where we need to pick up the unit test from. So we are defining the particular area so that the surefire plugin will be picking up the unit test from the particular path. And also, what are the unit tests? What are the tests? What are the functional tests? What are the unit tests that needs to be picked up? And what are the things that needs to be excluded? So, and how it needs to be done? It needs to be done in parallel, or it needs to be done in a step-by-step sequence or group by. So how they need to be done? All these things are defined in a particular files, and that we are providing as an input to the surefire plugin. That the task of the surefire plugin is used to pick up that particular file, that SNG file, and utilize that SNG plugin, and then it executes based on the things that are defined in that particular file. So let's define the dependency over here. Let's define the plugin over here. So as we already seen in the previous video, that we need to define build. Under the build is plugins. So under build, you can see all the things available, and we need to choose plugins. And under plugins, you can see what are available under plugins. So plugin is the only thing that is available under plugins. So plugin, and we need to configure plugins. So these are the various plugins that are available, clean, compile, and what is the purpose of those things has been told in the description over here. Clean plugin is used for cleaning up after the build, and compiler plugin compiles the Java source. Deploy plugin is used for deploying the build artifact to the remote repository. Failsafe plugin is used for running the failed test case, failed unit test. And then install plugin is used for installing the build artifact into a local repository. And then resources plugin, site plugin generates a site for the current project. Surefire plugin used for running the unit test we already discussed in an isolated class model. Verifier, UGR packaging plugin, reporting plugin, and tools plugin. So these are the various plugins that are available. But basically, as a part of our framework design, we are going to utilize mostly compiler plugin, say failsafe plugin, and then surefire plugin. So basically, mostly we'll be using compiler and surefire plugin. So these are mandatory. So click on the compiler plugin, open a new tab, And similarly, Shota plugin. And also, we can configure the tail shape plugin. So you can see what are the phases that are available were defined in the Maven lifecycle for compiler plugin, compile and test compile. Compile is used to compile the phase and is used to compile the main source files, and test compile is used to compile the test source files. This is what is useful for us. This is what is useful for developers. And let's go back. So this is how we are going to set up this plugin. So under the build, project, build, plugins, plugin, and this is how we are going to configure. Under the configuration, so group ID, artifact ID, and then the configuration is 1.8. Similarly, we need to configure Surefire plugin. So you can see the Surefire plugin is used during the test phase of the build lifecycle to execute the unit tests of an application. It generates the reports in plain text files and XML files. So basic reporting is supported by this, but we are not going to use this report. We are going to use the extent report. We are going to customize the report and we are going to use it. So Surefire plugin is used with TestNG for to use counters. So you can see what are the goals that are available under the Surefire plugin. It has only one goal, Surefire test, it is used for running the unit tests of an application. So you can see how to utilize it with TestNG. So this is how we are going to utilize. So we have configured the TestNG dependency. And so we are seeing what is the phase that is utilized for. It is used for test phase. It is used in the scope of the TestNG is used for test phase. And how to configure this plugin. So you can read out for here. So this is one step that is required to get started. You can create tests in our test source directory. As I already explained, that this is the directory structure which we are going to utilize for preparing our tests, for defining our tests, source tests. And they will be picked up, these tests will be picked up by the Surefire plugin as TestNG tests, and then it will be executing. So, as I already told, we are going to configure the TestNG.xml file using this. So let's copy from here and paste over here. So we have configured, we have overridden the Maven compiler plugin configurations and then the Surefire plugin configurations. And below you can see, so you can see whatever I was saying, the same thing was mentioned over here. This configuration will override the includes and exclude buttons and run all the tests in the suit XML files. So if you want to specify the test parameters You can do it like this. If you want to define what the property name, like if you are running for a Firefox browser, so you can define the property over here. So these property variables can be utilized in the test plugin, I mean the testng.xml file, and then from here we can configure, and this particular property can be utilized over there while executing the testng.xml file or while configuring the testng.xml file. And also how to use groups. As you already seen, if you wanted to group only these particular tests to be executed instead of going with the testng.xml file, instead of using the XML file, configuration file, we can go with the test that needs to be executed that is defined by the package. Under function test package, all the tests will be executed. Under perfect test package, the test will be executed. Running tests in parallel, this also can be defined over here, or we can define in the testng.xml file. Basically, we'll be defining all these configurations in testng.xml file rather than Surefire plugin configuration. So if you are running, if you wanted to run different suits, like assume you have two suits, like one is the basic smoke, and then assume like if you're having two modules, module one is defined with testng in testng.xml file, and module two related tests are defined in testng.xml, testng2.xml file. If you wanted to run both the tests under both modules at one shot, we will be configuring both the files over here. So it picks up testng1.xml file, all the related tests, and it gets executed, and then it will pick up testng2.xml file, and then it executes. So if you're doing full size and soup, it executes both of the things at one shot. And then how to use custom listeners and reporters. So we can configure even these things. So you can see over here how to configure the listeners. It is also like the system properties that we have defined, like if you wanted to use the default listeners, or if you wanted to configure a particular listeners, we can do it over here, or we can do it from the testng.xml file. Basically, we are not going to follow this one. We are going to do that in testng.xml file. When you are working on with testng, we are going to define how to customize those things and how to define the listeners and all those things over there. So these are all the various things that are available. So basically we are going to just configure the testng.xml file under the configuration stack of the Surefire plugin. This is what we are going to do basically. So some other things are available here, you can just go through if interested. And then we have seen the FailSafe plugin. So basically what it is used for, as I told, it is used by executing, re-executing the failed test cases. So designed to run integration tests, while the Surefire plugin is designed to run the unit test. The name chosen both because it is synonymous of Surefire, but it implies that when it fails. So it is used for running the failed test cases only. So that's the use of FailSafe plugin. So it has multiple phases, multiple goals to be executed: the integration tests, post-integration tests, and very fine. These are the various goals that are available as a part of this plugin. Integration and verify are the goals that are available. That is the life cycle. Sorry. So how to use this with testng.xml file? I can follow the simple example over here, and can skip all those things, the dependency configuration which you are seeing, and then this is the suit.xml file. This is the plugin configuration. Copy and then paste it. Okay, we didn't define the plugin tag. Let's remove this one. Okay. Now select all and then format. Control Shift F. So the configuration file has been formatted. The same shortcut is used in Java files also. It is basically not used for only Java files but also the XML files. Control Shift F is used for formatting. So all the configurations are completed. This is what basically we are going to use in the pom.xml file. In an advanced way, if you wanted to configure some other things, we can configure the site and all those things where basically the product related documentation will be available. We can configure that and we can configure the deploy plugin, override with the deploy plugin where that particular repository will be deployed to post compilation, and once everything is successful, we wanted to deploy it to the particular location, and that we can configure over here. That is an advanced topic, and we are not going to deal with those things. These are the basic things which is basically required for us. And one more thing is the profiles. Profiles, as we have seen, it is used for defining which environment, what are the plugins that are needed, what are the dependencies that are required, and the scope of that particular project is defined in the profiles. So basically, that's the theoretical idea of how to use a profile, and that also we are not covering as a part of this one. It is all advanced topics. If you are going to, when it is basically used by the developers to deploy into the particular production or the test environments or migration environment or staging environment, it's based on different environments they are going to deploy it into. But we are not going to generally do that. We are just going to have the particular server where we are going to execute our frameworks in. So we are going to use one particular environment. So basically we are not going to have a profile concept over here. So these are the basic things which are required for us. And this is all about my pom.xml file. So this is the configuration file from where Maven will pick up everything. If it was not defined over here, it will go and check in the parent form. So it will basically fetch it from the parent form, and if something is overwritten in this configuration file in this particular project, it will overwrite and it will utilize whatever the configuration is made over here, and then it start executing at the compiling. So this is all about Maven practical hands-on. So assume like we wanted to update this project with all the dependencies and everything which are defined over here, you can just right click on the project and then select Maven update project, click on OK. So you can see earlier we used to have some error configured, show some kind of error because these plugin configurations have been not updated and some of the configurations which are done might not have been updated. That's the reason it was showing some sort of error, kind of red mark over here. Once you click on update, then everything goes away. So you can see all the dependencies, everything has been downloaded and placed under Maven dependencies. So this is all about Maven. So we have completed one of the main component of the framework design, that is Maven, a build automation tool or a build configuration or build tool. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching.